T-ball coach that ever told me to quit. Next up, we've got a real treat. You've seen him around Manhattan. You've seen him around Queens. He's from the Bronx. Yeah. It's Fable Leo, everybody.
Every time I go on a vacation, I always have a couple friends ask me to bring them back a souvenir. And I tell them to go fuck themselves. To me, buying somebody a souvenir is basically you buying them a gift so you can prove he was what you say he was at. Maybe I was lying. Maybe I was lying. I think people who ask you to buy them a souvenir are a dickhead. Because what's their hidden agenda, right? Maybe they want to lie to their friends that they was what, saying that they was where I was at. Blaine came on to the horse with that shit, right? Every grandmother I ever met, they all have that Welcome to Las Vegas refrigerator magnet on their face. Only place they ever went to gamble was Atlantic City and Foxwoods. You can have somebody narrate, and somebody gives them a souvenir. Perfect voice to be an Italian. You're like, hey, see this gift in the ear? Every time you walk by, you can see it. I want you to think of me as a place that you haven't been yet. So I don't give people souvenirs, and I don't accept them. I never ask celebrities for autographs. For what? So I can tell my friends they signed that napkin on a piece of paper? It's not like my mind can memorize the signature and I can forge it and get cash some checks out, right? What do you do is scribble their initials? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Oh, Schwarzenegger's 25 fucking letters. Every time I see a friend take a picture with a celebrity, always does that stupid fucking pose and like, you know what that means, right? They're like, he's not lying, he really did beat me. Celebrity ever does that shit to me, this is what I'm gonna do. Put their finger on my dick, I don't fucking do that shit. I have 8 kids. And every morning when they wake me up, it scares the shit out of me. You're supposed to wake somebody up with 8 people surrounding the bed. Feel like I'm about to be abducted by aliens. Other things, I feel like I'm waking up inside of a hospital bed. Inside, I'm like, am I alright? Then I get up, I follow them all out the room. They all make that left towards the kitchen so I can make my breakfast. I make that right so I can take my morning piss and morning shit. You ever try to pour a bowl of cereal while you're holding in a piss or shit? Don't forget, I got 8 kids. That's 7 bowls of cereal, 1 baby bottle I gotta pour. Kids clog the toilet up, they never let me know. I need to buy one of those Dominican drug dealer toilets in Washington Heights. Seen them in the movies, right? Cops will go raid the house, they just flush a key down the toilet. That's what I really need in my life, a powerful fucking toilet. Night times are the worst. We'll be whispering to each other, tiptoeing around the house. I gotta get up and check on it. Let's say it isn't going on, alright? And they're all sleeping, or they're pretending they're sleeping. And I get some paranoid because I'm thinking, like, yo, is my fucking house haunted? Like, what's going on? Friends call me up. They go, why don't you come over to my house? Bring your wife and kids. I'm like, I got 8 kids. They hang up on me. Sometimes friends call me up. They're like, yo, I got beef. I need you to get my bag. I'm like, yo, I got 8 kids. I hang up on them. The times I was smoking weed, the cops caught me. I went to arrest me. I'm like, go for some police. I got 8 kids. I let my phone show them pictures. Like, oh, this is weird. I fucking run. Back to my kids, like, they never tell me when we have toilet paper. When you got a couple kids at home, that toilet paper goes fast. When you got 8 kids, that toilet paper disappears like Thanos to snap his fucking fingers. You know what I'm talking about, right? Kids, man. Drop them off at school, I rush back home. So I created them in this video game I got. This wrestling game. I created my character, looks just like me. Notice you can create a midget. You can create a midget, you can create a child. You don't have any kids. woman in there. I never do it in real life, so I gotta release that anger. Let me tell you this, I have to fucking try this. It's amazing. That's how the video games are now. You can create anybody you want, it looks exactly like them. Getting back to the kids, like when I hear them talking, I try to sneak up on the room, but I'm like too fat to tippy-toe, like they even coming and shit. So I was thinking about installing like this big hole across the ceiling. Just jump up. My baby mom won't be mad because we can hang clothes out to dry on it. You know? I can do pull-ups on it. They put like a little speed bag, boxing bag. I don't know. This past Thanksgiving, I thought about kidnapping Martha Stewart. A friendly kidnapper, you know? I'm not saying my baby moms can't cook, I'm just saying that's fucking Martha Stewart. You know what I mean? Every time I played out the scenario in my head, Martha flipped the fuck out on me. I poisoned a turkey. She stabbed me in the neck with a kitchen knife. Thanks for laughing at Martha Stewart murdering me in front of my family on Thanksgiving. Maybe I should become a Christian and go to an island and try to convert some natives, right? That's what I'm doing next. Oh, man. Sometimes I come home, the kids will be jumping on the beds, right? They're having fun. But those jumping on the bed squeaks sound like somebody's fucking my girl on the room squeaks. That cartoon, the Snorks? The Snorks. Snakes. The Pope with the Snorks. You know, I gotta get back to my 8 kids. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm sorry, everybody have that done.
Give it up for Fable and Leo.